Hey there, folks. Dr. Groovy Scott Grove from GroovyMusicLessons.com. Beginner bass time for country music. As long as you know the names of your notes, we'll be doing fine. Okay? If you don't know them, look them up. It's the internet. It's easy to find the names of your notes. So as long as you know, E, A, B, A, you know, we're good to go. Okay? But if you've never played bass in your whole life, we're still going to be okay. All right? So, again, if you know the notes, we are good to go. The kind of stuff we're going to be covering will be 100% in open keys today. This means that we will actually have a lot of open strings. By open, I mean that there's actually no fingers on them. Okay? So you will have like... So that'll be some of it. That's called a root fifth pattern. But then it will come up to... other kinds of stuff. We'll do walking patterns. Let's say like we're going to be doing... first of all, we're going to be doing Family Tradition by Hank Jr. Then we're going to be doing... somewhere during this whole thing, we'll be doing some George Strait, Neon Moon. That's actually got some walking that's kind of like... Okay, so that kind of stuff. And we're also going to have walk-ups and walk-downs, okay? So if we're playing in a song, we'll be going what's called the root fifth, which is the walk-up, the walk-down, walk-down, walk-up. Kind of stuff going on too. Okay, so it's not only going to be just a whole bunch of open notes, I'm just saying they are in open keys. So they will be in the key of E, most of them. Almost everything's in the key of E. Neon Moon will be in the key of A. I have taken all the lyrics off of here. I have taken the bass guitar off of here. Number one, bass guitar gone, so I can play each one at the end of teaching you the song. And I won't be playing at all. It'll be a backing track for you. Of course, put on headphones or get a good sounding rig to listen to this stuff on, because the bass will be the hardest thing to pick out. Okay, and the other thing with the vocals gone, it's kind of hard to know where you're at. But then again, copyright strikes, can't have them on there. Okay, it's just the way it is. So you might listen to the real songs. You can get them all. Downloaded real easy, or just listen to them here on YouTube. And these are pretty much note for note correct. I was able to sit there and mix them myself and take certain things out, take all the harmonies out, you know, put one guitar hotter than the other, and so forth. Other things we'll be doing will be walking things that are a little different than others. Instead of there'll be stuff like okay, so that kind of stuff will be in there as well. So if this sounds like your bag, what it is you need, okay, join me. Today's axe is very groovy. Let's show you that. Why? Just because I like talking about gear. This here is actually a Dillion, D-I-L-L-I-O-N, with mother of toilet seat finish on it. Okay, I even did the pick guard that way. I put in Fender Lace Sensor Silver pickups in it, changed the bridge, changed most everything, but what a great axe. And as always, I always change the neck plate. Here we got a naked girl, spread eagle, sitting with the tiger. You know, that's the best part of the base. Okay, so we're going to get to it. And like I said, Family Tradition will be the very first song, and it'll be in the key of E. All right, catch you in a little bit. Okay, we're going to be doing Family Tradition here in just a moment. It will only have three chords, but we'll have some walking up, and we'll have some walking down. I have to teach you all that stuff before we get started, okay? And it goes like this. Okay, we have to start with some root fifth stuff. What root fifth is simply this. I told you that if you needed help knowing the notes, get out of here. Okay, I'll help you a little bit with that, but anyway, root fifth is when you go. So you're actually hitting the root of the chord. We're going to be in the key of E, so that's always going to be the root, and then the fifth. What's the fifth mean? The fifth note of the major scale. Okay, that's actually what it means. So a B is the fifth note of a scale, and that's the way that goes. How do we determine that? Okay, I'm going to go way up here. Do you know your way around up there? Let's hope so, because I'm going to try to teach you in E all the way up here. This is going to be the same for everything you ever try to figure out in your life. And that's the old do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. Okay, and we count that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so we got 1, which is at the 7th fret on the A string. That's E. So that's where we're always going to start. 1, 2 is going to be 2 more frets higher, so the 9th fret, A string. 2, so 1, that's the key we're in. Now, from that key, we got to find the 5th, because we're going to be playing root 5th bass, which is the typical. After all this, I'm not going to have to tell you much more on the other songs about how to do certain things. I just want to get this root 5th stuff out of the way. I want to get the walking up and walking down ideas ingrained in your skull. That way we can do a lot of these without more explanation on how to do them. Okay, so again, we're going up to the 7th fret of the A string, which is an E. So is your low E. Okay, that way you know you got it in the right place. Up to the 9th, which is 2. We're going to the D string to the 6th fret. So that's 1, 2, 3. Now to the 7th fret, 4. And 5. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's just practice on that. Why? Because we have to. And this is part of your walk down and your walk up. See? That is 100% your walk ups and your walk downs. There can be. Exactly the 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will be walking up, and 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 will be walking down. And your root fifth. But you're like, the fifth you said was up here. Okay, yeah, it is. It's a B note, which is the same as this low note. Okay, so if you can do it, whenever you're playing like a note, the fifth will always be right above it. So you have the note here, the E. Okay, so it'll be right above it, or where we figured it out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Or both. So there's lots of ways to do this, and that was them, two ways. Okay, so when you do get up to this fifth, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you're going to hear the words root fifth for the rest of your life. People be going, oh, it's just a root fifth and E. So that means you're going to be an E and you're going to be playing. Or you'll be going way down here to open E and then a B note here on this A string second fret, which is what we're going to be doing during the song. Why didn't we go above the low E? Because we don't have a five string, or at least I don't. Here, I'm teaching you, of course, on a four string. So when you play the low E, you gotta play the fifth up. Why did I teach it to you way up here? Because we go one, two, we can't play the three. It would be here. Then four and five. So root, fifth, then root. Fifth, root, fifth, root, fifth. Root means one. Okay? So that's what we're talking about. You can play it anywhere you want, but you still have to go E, B, E, B. Now the fourth, what note's that going to be? Okay, we just have to count it up. One, two, three, four. Starting from the E. One, two, three, four. What note is that? If you're looking at it and trying to figure out and going, I just don't know, this is too hard. Again, we simply need to know that you know the notes. Okay, that's actually going to be an A, and that's important because if we're an E, the A is always going to be, or the four, is always just going to be straight down to the next string, just one string down. Whatever fret you're playing your one on, that's your four. So if we're going in one, doing the root fifth, going to the four, root fifth, five, back to the one. See how that's coming together? Okay. And if we're doing those walk things, going one, two, three, four, five, so we're going. Up to the four. Okay? How? By going one. So we go one, two, three, four. Backward. Four, three, two, one. Backward. Four, three, two, one. How come we're going? How come we're doing that? Oh, because we got crickets. because we're hitting the B, which is a fifth, because you can always just go straight up to the next note if there's a note above it, above the one. And we're just hitting the fifth of that one. One, two, three, four, five. So, walk up again from one, here being the one now. And you just count. Two, three, four. Okay, so that's what we're doing. It's basically that easy. Walk up by using two, three, four. Okay, then backward. We're going to go backward again. Now upward. It's always going to be that walk up, and it's going to be the one, two, three, four, five, so. Or backward. Okay, like that. We're gonna have crickets for some reason. It sounds like a ground loop, but that's the way she's gonna be. Okay, so that's what we're gonna have. Okay, we're going to start this thing in the key of E. I'll show you how to play this in another key, which is still E, but in another place. You're more than welcome to play it right up here where we were. Why not? Okay, and after the tune's over, like I said, I'll play the track. You just play along with it. Without the words again, we may get lost. It comes in and goes out of different chords and notes, kind of different unless you know the words. Okay? I might throw out some words every now and then, but I'll definitely yell when we're walking up to, if I'm going E, okay, then you're going, walk up to A, walk back down to E, walk up to B, okay? Now that one there is going to look a little different because we're actually going to start this way, because we're going to be going, because this was the B, the same walk going up, we're just not up here, okay? So it's no different than before, we're just way down here, okay? And there are going to be notes that are open, like E. Okay, and our 5 is up here, 2nd fret on the A string, because it's a B note. We done figured that out. We're only going to have E, A, and B are the 3 chords in this song. Why? Because 1, that's one of them, because that's where we're starting, on the 1 note, which is an E. That's always, again, the key we're in. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, that's an A note. And we're also going to have a 5 note. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and that's going to be a B. Now again, the cool thing is when you're figuring this stuff out, the note we're playing in, the key we're in, okay, is there's the E, then the 4 is just straight down. Every time, no matter where you're at on a bass, you can have a 30 string bass, and it's always going to be that way on every single string, every single time. So your root will be whatever key you're in. The 4 will be just straight down. And the 5th will just be 2 up from there. Okay? Okay? Magic. And also the other way is exactly opposite of this. If we got lower string to work with, we've got our 1 where it was. And we determined that the 5th would be right above it, okay? And 5. Why? Because root, 5th, root, 5th, root, walk, root, 5th, root, walk. Okay? We can walk backward to the 5. Walk back up. We need all of this for this song. Okay, once you learn it once, you've got it, okay? And it's there forever in your brain because it never changes. The walks are going to be the same. Very cool stuff. But once it's there, you got this stuff, especially in country, okay? Now that we know that the 5th is there, the 4 is always 2 frets before the 5. Okay, so there's the 4. Okay, so you can actually go 1, 4, and 5, again, because you know the 4 is 2 frets behind the 5. Okay, now you got it. Okay, I'll teach you this song again, family tradition. I'll help you all the way, of course, and anything else I need to point out, I will. The thing is, the verses and choruses, the choruses are always the part that we all know, like, tell me, Hank, why do you drink, and why do you roll smoke? That's the chorus. We all know what that is. The verses are the first part. Country music singers have always been a real close family. Okay, so that's the verses. What's going to happen is, on a song like this, and a couple more of these, the verses and the choruses don't necessarily go as quick as you think they would. They go slower, not tempo-wise, but they just jump in there faster. So leave me alone, I'm singing all night long, it's a family tradition. Tell me, Hank, why do you drink? Because you would think think it would last longer. So, singing, oh, no, no, it's a family tradition. Tell me, Hank, why? You would think it would come in that quick, but it does not. It's singing, oh, singing all night long. It's a family tradition. Tell me, Hank, why do you drink? It comes in really quick like that. So we'll get familiar with it, all right? So here we go. It's going to count 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And don't forget, these are stick counts. Nobody's saying 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? We're playing music in a band now, folks. So it's time to hear sticks clicking together. So it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we're going to just go E. Okay, because that's a root. You can use this one, which is what's used on the album. So you got your E at the second fret on the D string. D, D sharp, E. Then A. Then the fifth. And when we go to B, it'll be. And if you want to, you can just play the low E and still that same fifth. Walks. So anytime you can walk up, you pretty much want to. Okay, so that's going to be B, and just go 2, 3, 4, 5. So there's B, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so I'll catch myself in a second. Okay, 2, 3, 4, up to 4, not 5. That's why I screwed it. I screwed the pooch, so up to 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and that gets us back home to 1. Okay, let's try some of this and see what. All right. Again, it will go click, 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 and click, but all together like 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's what the clicks are going to sound like this. 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, from that, and don't forget, don't use your thumb on these strings unless you're going. Unless you're doing that kind of crap. Generally, you don't want to go. It's just not a good habit to get into. It's good to use these two fingers. So. Okay, and that walk up that happened right here, that always lets people know that something is getting ready to happen. Okay, and it's your job to be the leader of any band. The drummer counts you in, but from then on, you have to do little runs or walks or just a note up, like. Those things, okay? To get us up there, you let everybody else know because they're not listening. They're only listening to you to let them know when the chord is going to change and what it's going to change to. All the rest of us will listen and we'll know if you're getting ready to go to the 5 or if you're going to go to the 4 just by what you play. Okay? So you have to lead notes. You have to be the one that actually knows how to play the song. Everybody else follows what you're doing on the bass. Okay, so here at the beginning it went 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so the one note gets chopped off. Country music singers have always been a real close family. Some of my can, folks. Don't disown few others than me. I guess it's because time has changed my direction. Leave me alone, I'm singing all night long. It's a family tradition. Why do you drink? I know they're getting ready to go to different chords, okay? And like I said, I'll yell all this at you. So here we go. The count is on. And we will do the walking right before the singing. It leads us right there. So we're going to be doing this root and fifth instead of this one. Do that one if you want. It makes no difference to me. It's up to you from here on out. Okay? But I'm just letting you know I'm going to play here for now. Because that's the way it goes on the album for whatever reason. You'd think they'd want to go to a lower note, but who knows? Here we go. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here we go. Walk. Walk up there to the B, E, E, A. Now walk B, walk up. Walk that you'll probably have, or the walk up that you might be having problems with, will be going from the A okay, we go up to the fourth fret on the low E. That's actually part of the original run because we're going in B, so we're going here to the okay, so that one there is fourth fret on the low E, open A, fret to the first fret, and then B. Or, I'm sorry, a walk down. That's it. So the one little thing. Is what it is, walking back up. Okay, so we'll start from the beginning. You'll be able to hear when the choruses are. Just watch me for the changes and listen for me to change it. Going right from that E again, right from the beginning. 1, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Walk up to E.
walk up to the E, walk again. A, that little walk. B, walk up.
Playing all these notes like this. So we have to shut them up at some point. We don't want to go. Okay, so we have to go. And two, and three, and four. You just give it one thing of rest, one measure, not a measure, one count, like one. So one, and two. So just enough in between each note, okay? You'll start to feel the bounce up. So when you bounce back up, your note stops, okay? And I stop it by putting my fingers on the strings. I don't slap them down. So I go. If you hear that rattle, and it's no thing, it's just part of the bass. Again, if you're going doom, boom, doom, boom, boom. Honestly, when you bounce back up, that's when you're supposed to shut the note off. Some people will let them ring. Is that any good? It's fine. Just listen to what the song actually does. Okay? Like this. Two, three, four, one, two. Here's letting it go. This. You saw a couple different things. So it's imagine, I'm sorry, it's a matter of if you want to go or the first time I just went okay, so you have to figure out just by listening how it actually goes. Listen to your part and listen to the bass drum. You have to match that bass drum perfectly. If he hits a note twice, you hit it twice. If he hits a bass drum once, you hit it once. You'll be able to tell by listening to that bass drum, also called a kick drum. Okay, so if that bass drum is going, that means you'll be going. But on this actual song, you go. Because it's going boom, boom, boom. So follow that bass drum. And excuse my rapping skills, or my crapping skills. Okay, so follow me one more time while we're playing it. And I'll keep yelling stuff out and singing where the chorus goes, maybe a little bit, to kind of help you know where you're at. Then I'll let the track play, and then I'll do a Milli Vanilli and just kind of pretend I'm playing so you can follow along. Okay, but I'll have the bass shut completely off so you can play along with it. Okay, so here we go with me playing with you, just like we did the last time, all the way from the beginning. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Over and over, some slicks trying to make my prediction.
Okay. Hope some of that helped you in there. But see how, especially walking up to the chorus, because it gives you a big heads up that something's getting ready to happen when you do the walk. So come on, tell me, Hank, why do you drink? Sorry, it's out of my range. But anyway, it's letting you know that chorus is coming. Okay? Great big huge thing. Gotta love it. Okay, I'm going to turn off both my volume knobs. Not say a word. Give you the backing track, okay? And we'll start from the beginning. I'll count you in with the drum clicks. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so what did I do there at the very end that you weren't looking at? Right when it went... ending of the song, anyway. I actually took my finger, hit it on the string, because it was going like this. And when you go up to the double dots, which is on the side, mine's just a big old hunk of something, but you go up to the 12th fret, again, double dots on the side. It's the only place you'll have them. You take your finger and go. That's the key we were in, was E. So if you got E here, you have E here. So. Nothing special. Anyway, so I hope that helped out. Family Tradition by Hank Williams Jr. Again, check it all out and see what's in there, what's not, what you want to play. You can overplay if you want, you can underplay, but listen to the drummer. No matter what, listen to the drummer. Not what he says on breaks, because he's usually wrong, but what he's playing. Okay? Even if he's playing it wrong, play whatever he's playing. Okay? You can yell at him later. All right, we'll get to another one. Okay, folks, now we're going to do Folsom Prison Blues by Johnny Cash. The weird thing is, this one is slightly out of tune. It's not going to matter a whole big bunch, but yep, if you're wondering what it is, that's what it is. could I have sat there and tuned it all day? No, they won't let me do that. But if you have Audacity, yeah, you can do it that way. Anyway, so I did this one here second because it has the same three chords, E, A, and B. Okay, because I just want to get this stuff drilled in your head. It plays faster, okay? And we have a couple little things that I definitely need for you to know. This was played on an upright bass, or a stand-up bass, whatever you want to call it. When we're doing the E and the fifth, instead of going... it definitely goes the low E, and then the second fret of the A string, the fifth. I hear the train coming, it's coming round the bend. I ain't seen sunshine since I don't know when. Okay, we got to run up there. That's open E, second fret. F sharp, fourth fret, which is G sharp, and then A. Okay, so we got ain't coming, coming around the bend. I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. Okay, I'm stuck in Folsom Prison. Time keeps dragging on. Has that ended again from the last tune? Okay, so we're going to the A sharp, open A sharp, I'm sorry, A flat here, A sharp, B. And that one there, just to show you, because I'll get back to it, is going to be this B, 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 A, F sharp. E. Okay, and what all that is time keeps dragging on. When I hear that train blowing on down to San Antonio. Okay, so that's what that is. Okay, so once again, with me caterwauling, it goes, the guitar at the beginning goes. Come in on that E, okay? And the guitar is not on here because I didn't put it on her. Didn't want too many noises. But so at the beginning, it actually goes. Then we go boom, 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 like a tuba. Okay, when the guy's playing stand-up bass like it, it doesn't have hardly any sustain to it, so it don't go. It's like a. Like a tuba. Bunch of farts. Okay? So I know some of your farts are longer than others, but yes. Again, what's called staccato. Just shut it up by doing this. Or you can use your other fingers to stop it while you're getting ready to hit the next one. And don't forget to watch down here. I'm doing what you need to be doing. You don't be going like this. That's just the worst thing you can do. If you do that, your habits will be horrible in the future, and it will take as long as it's going to take now, or longer, to unbreak these nasty habits and learn how to play correctly. Okay? So, leave that thumb away. Okay, so the intro again. Which you won't hear. Yeah, hear that train coming. It's rolling around the bend. I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. Okay? You can go right up that way, or you don't have to walk. Okay? It's a matter of what you want to do and what you hear. So whatever you hear, do that or do what you want. But I like to go again. 0-4, 0-2-4. Time keeps dragging on, and it definitely does this, which is 4 open 1 2, keeps it rolling on down to San Antonio. Okay, and that train keeps rolling on down to San Antonio. Okay, so the best way to do this is to get into it. And here we go. Again, a lot of it will be familiar from the last tune.
I hear the train coming, rolling round the bend. I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when.
At the end there, it's like, hang my head and then it goes. Oh. Okay, because the guitar comes back in. Producing.
Hang my head and cry.
Okay, and that's the same run we did before. You hit the E one time, then slide it from 2 to 4. I do this. New term, hammer on. So we got to slide from 2 to 4. So we start with the E, low E. Now we do a hammer on from 2 to 4. Okay, so we actually hammer the finger down to the 4th fret. Okay, so you got it. Then finally the E again, but it's a higher E. Just like we always do. You know the high E now. And that's the way it ends. Okay. Slide. Hammer on. End it on E. Hit the low E again if you want to. It's always nice to have that bass rumble on your butt. Okay? So one more time with me caterwauling again, try to help you out. And then we'll just let you roll on your own, because you have enough knowledge from the previous song, if you didn't skip it, to know what's going on. If you did skip it, you're lost. Okay? So here we go. I'll rattle out the lead guitar part for you. She goes on that one. So at the very end, it goes back up to the 5, which is the B, because we go. So at the very end, again, it's at the end of the guitar solo. So I'm sorry.
And that's what tortures me.
You're like, what was that? Okay, now you know. Okay, so here's Folsom Prison Blues for you. And going to play the backing track, and I'm going to hang back and just pantomime this thing. Okay, so here we go. Folsom Prison Blues, Johnny Cash, F-O-L-S-O-M, not F-S-U-M, so if you try to find it, F-O-L-S-O-M, Folsom Prison Blues, okay? So, we'll do something different on the next one. I think I'm actually going to bring out, let's do one more song in the key of E, okay? Going to do... I'm looking at Big City by Merle Haggard. Okay, get that one ready. Big City by Merle Haggard. Coming up right after this one. Okay, we're going to do Merle Haggard's Big City. And key of E also. E, A, and B all the way through it. Difference in this one is it actually is a workout because it walks all the way through like this. Song. It never stops. Okay? So this one does something that you're kind of used to, but a little different. We're going to be doing the low E in the 4th fret. And then here's actually the 5, even though it's the 2nd fret of the A string. Back to the 4th fret of the low E, and that is it. Okay, so the frets are 0, 4, next string, 2, 4, 0, 4, 2, 4, 0, 4, 2, 4. And on the A, it'll do the same thing. Back to E. Now the B has to start here. It's kind of a two ways you can play this. You can go here with your B with the middle finger, so 2nd fret on the A string, 1st fret on the D string, and 4th fret way up here with your pinky on the D string. Okay. Or you can go, which is 2 still on the A string, all the way up to 6 on the A string, 4 on the D string, back to 6. Okay. Or back here. And you do have that walk. So if you're here, it's better because you actually get to do this big crab walk. So it's just backward from what we've always done. Not what we've always done. It's actually the same as we've always done. Sorry. But you'll be having like your middle finger here. So, two, open, 4, 2, open. Okay? So that's it. A. Back to E. If it goes to B, it goes to... So it never stops walking, it never waits, even it never does the same note twice in a row, ever. Okay? And I'll probably have to do some vocals behind this one just to keep my place on this one, because the changes are in a weird place. So if you know the song, cool. If not, get used to the way the, the things go. Okay? So I'm going to do my best just to get through it without telling you where to go. Because you're going to see me switching. I might change some of the words. Just so I go, I'm tired of this dirty old A. And I'm eating much work. And never enough B. B, 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 B. Whenever it goes to the B, it'll go boom, ba, do, da. One time. Then do, da, da, da. I'm tired. I'll walk off my steady job today. Okay, so I'll throw as many notes out letting you know when we switch as I can. Okay, again, just 3 chords, but it does that walking 100% of the time. Never, ever, ever does it play the same note twice in a row. So you'll know if you went, no, you got it wrong. It changes every single note. But this here's one of the killers that is great for you. After you get this, you've got a lot behind you, and it'll be really great for the next song coming up, which is Neon Moon. And we'll be in the key of A then, with some cool little stuff going along with other things. Okay, so here we go. Big City, the first time through. Let me see how the intro goes. I think it goes to the B. think. No, E. Okay, so it does. Actually, it stays on E, goes to A, and then back to E, up to B. Well, I'm tired of this. Yeah, so it's got the full A, E, A, E, B, as it will be throughout the entire song. So here we go. I'll, like I said, do as much help as I can. So E. A. E. B, boy. E. Well, I'm tired of this dirty old A. I hope that helped. When I say boy, that means B, and I'm trying not to say B because it sounds like E, A, B, C, D, E, G. They all sound the same when you're trying to yell them. So I like to yell like Edward Apple Boy, you know, different things like that. So I'll try to throw in some of those type of things, so you can get used to it, okay? And change up the words so I can throw in Edward, Apple, and Boy, okay? Or Edward, Asshole, whatever, you get it, okay? And I'll try to sing some of the words again just to help you through it. I know that one was that one's a worker. Okay, so here we go. Starts off E, A, E, and B. And remember, with the B again, it'll just do that every single time. One time, then da 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 da, the walk down. It's five. Actually, it's called, remember, a 5-4-3-2-1. So again, it's just that learning your theory thing. We never even got up to 8-1-2-3-4-5-6-7, and then 8 = 1. But we will learn a lesson soon, okay? So here we go with Big City again, with me doing the same thing, but yelling out apple and boy and stuff. Boy is B, apple A, Edward E, okay, when I can. So Edward, apple, Edward, boy is how the beginning starts. Edward. Apple. Edward. Boy. Edward. I've been working every day, 'cause I was apple. Edward has got a thing to show. Anything I boy, and there's that Edward. No, but they've got an apple. Think it's Edward, and boy should have some Edward. Turn me Edward, set me free, apple. We're in the middle of my Edward. Be all I got coming to my boy. And Edward, keep your retirement and your apple. Social security, Edward. A big city turned me boy. Set me up, Edward. Edward. Apple. Edward, boy, walk down, Edward. I've been working every day since I was an apple. I haven't got a Edward thing to show or anything I've boy. And there's folks, that's Edward, who never work. He's got an apple. I think some Edwards should find a boy to have some Edward. Me, Edward, be free. An apple in the middle of Big Edward. And give me Edward, Edward, to a boy. Walk down to Edward to keep you. Edward, boy, I'm sorry, boy now, Edward, by golly, I almost did that impossible feat, I almost got away with it, I told you I would get away with it, but I didn't, I almost got away with it, okay, now that you have so much under your belt with that one twice, I'm going to do it now, with just me doing the vocal, not the bass guitar. I'll be muting my bass, and then I'll play it again with me just playing and with no vocal. Okay, so you'll get two tracks. One to kind of let you know where you're at with the vocals, and I won't tell you where we're at. You just have to try to follow what's going on. I'll be playing still, but I won't be telling you the chords. I'll just be singing the regular words. The second time, I just let it play through. I'll be Milli Vanilli faking again, but I will not be singing anything. Okay? So you get it twice here. So here we go. Thank you.
enough play. And I'm tired of these dirty old sidewalks. I think I'll walk off my steady job today. Set me loose, set me free. Somewhere in the middle of Montana. Give me all I got coming to me. And keep your retirement and your so-called social security. A big city turned me loose and set me free. Never work, but you got money. I think it's time to work. Anything I've done. And there's folks who never work, but they got plenty. I think it's time guys like me had some fun. Somewhere in the middle of Montana. And give me all I've got coming to me. And keep your retirement and your so-called social security. A big city turned me loose and set me free.
Okay, now if you've listened, I did forget to take out the bass guitar in this. So you'll actually hear stuff going on like, working every day since I was 20. Stuff like that. So listen to it, despite what I'm doing, and see if you can pick up what's actually going on. It's doing about 90% of what I showed you, but since the bass is actually here, you can actually hear it and try to figure out what's going on by all the things that you've learned. It just happened to work out this way to your advantage, okay? So you can actually hear what's going on. I'll be back here just playing what I normally play, and that'll be that. So you know how this works. This one's all yours. Here we go. Thank you. Okay, there you go. A couple other things you'll hear is the walking up on some of these, and it'll go instead of the low E, it'll walk up from like the B. That. Okay, so that's B from the. So, walking back to, up to that, so. Then. And it might walk up from the E to the A. I've heard it do that too. So you'll actually get this. And then. Very cool walking lines that are built in there for you to have at. Okay, I'm going to turn off my buzz machine and get you on to another one here, which again will be the Brooks and Dunn tune. So we'll get that one next. Go into the key of A and learn some new stuff. All right. Okay, it's time for something Brooks and Dunn did. Yeah, they done did it. Neon Moon. Okay, it's got a couple of parts that are odd, but they're not really odd once they get used to them. If you think there was an amazing Rhythm Aces song way back when, and another band covered it. Let's see, what was that thing called? Third Rate Romance. Third Rate Romance. Some Rendezvous. And it had the same bass line as this. Low Rent Rendezvous, that's what it was. Okay, the bass line in this is in, of course, in the key of A. We go to D, dog, which is that string by itself. This one. The one that's tuned up to that. And we got an E. Okay, no more B's in this song. Well, there will be a B when we're playing E because we're going. There's a B. But it's just part of the E doing the root fifth thing again. Okay, so while we're in this A thing, check it out. Let's let you just hear the beginning and you'll know better what I'm talking about. Okay, so what your part will be is. Okay, kind of odd to do. Not that I even caught it right that time, but it's a very odd one, and just know that these are in it. I'll play along with it so you can hear what I'm doing, like this. Be A on the A string, go to the 4th fret, 2nd fret on the D string, so you have, and that's it, okay, that click is just me hammering against there. The thing that makes each one of these different, which is every other one, is we actually do what's called a pushed beat before we go to that second fret. So when we hit that fourth fret is before we normally should. Okay, so it's the second time we play two notes on that. So we do it one time, then twice. You know, so it comes around weird, but it's very cool for anything. Again, it's the same as Third Rate Romance, same type of exact thing going on. This push cha-cha beat, the cowboy cha-cha. If you ever tell anybody you're playing that, they're going to run to the dance floor. Okay, so again. Okay, so I'll try to be quiet when I'm supposed to be quiet. Okay, can you hear that anticipated note and you put it in before you're supposed to? It seems like, almost like if you were to do this. Okay, so it's just like putting in the slide, but you take out the slide and only play when you would have arrived there. Okay, so it's... Just play with me, I'll just keep doing this. Very weird to get mastered, okay? So get mastered and get baited. Mastered and baited, okay. I'm not sure what that means, but sure it means something. Okay, and again, the second one is, so twice with the finger on the fourth fret. Okay, so first time, just the anticipation. Second time, then anticipate again, now twice. And it does that throughout the whole song, except for the chorus. When you lose your one and only, then we just go back to going in. Typical root fifth stuff. We'll go to the D, which can be anywhere. You could do, I like doing just the D string. So you got a D string and an A string. Then E. And the, it's just root fifth, so. Go up here to the fifth fret on the A string and go, when you lose your one and only, there's room here for the lonely, broken dream. Okay, so it does have the D with the fifth. Time it goes to that D and the E where you're doing the root fifth thing is when you lose your one and only. That's the chorus. The chorus is no longer than that. Okay, so let's get going. And again, it's just the first time has that anticipation. Second time. And it is only about getting it right. How to tell you to get it right? No real way. You just have to feel this one. So I waited till later to get this one. There's worse that I could have drug out, but it's nice that we get something different going on. But still we have our root fifth. Thank you. you're doing that root fifth, it does it around time three times. It goes. That's one time, then two, three. Now back to the A thing. Okay, so that's the only part I can tell you is it does that three times. Okay, there's solos in here, but they go exactly like the verses do. Okay, so let's go ahead and play through them. And I'll let you know when something's coming up. I doubt that I'll sing anything, but we'll see what happens. I'll still yell out apples, dog, and Edward to you. Okay, so apples, Edward, and dog. Always use dog, the key of dog. First time there's no double note, second time there is on everything. When we go to the D chord, because we have these open strings on every single one, we're going to do A. Told you all that. Okay, here we go in A, apple. To the D, you can do it up here or up here, or you can do it, like I said, open. And it goes, okay, coming up to that. So, if you want to play it up there because you're running up there, because if you're smoking, dancing, or you can either one. Okay, that walk up is simply A, second fret, third fret, fourth fret. Then here, if you want to. Third time. So that's every single thing in the whole song. Okay? No more surprises. Here we go. From the beginning. Apple.
Bible, walk it up.
Let's do this whole thing one more time, and then I'll let you just have it on your own, okay? So I'll still yell the same old things, and we'll get it right together, hopefully. Here we go. Apple.
Apple.
Upstairs. Okay, folks, that's it for this particular lesson. Again, if you like these for the bass, let me know, and I'll do some more. If not, we'll do something else for the kazoo players. All right. I actually do have that juice harp thing. Boy, bow, boy, bow. It's already on here. Look it up. Anyway, you guys stay groovy. I'm gonna keep low down and. If you guys ever buy anything from Dillion, I've got four of their axes here, actually. Four of them. Three right there, and this one. Just write Dillion, D-I-L-L-I-O-N, guitars at AOL.com. Talk to John Dillion. Say, hey, Scott Grove sent me, or Dr. Groovy sent me, and he'll give you, like, free gig bags and free straps and all this stuff and like $50 off. So that'll save your tax or your shipping or something. So if you mention my name, honestly, it does that. So amazing instruments, they'd be sold if they weren't, you know, so happy to use these. Okay, you guys stay groovy. I already am, as you know, and I am out of here.